What I have a problem with is that, and I've expressed this to them, okay, and I've tweeted it, I do have a strong problem with two men who beat women, who are on record beating women, who are being sued for beating women, who have been to jail for beating women, who don't take care of their children, okay, who kick children out of their girlfriend's bodies. Yeah, I don't agree that these two should be revived in any kind of way or offered a platform in that way. Now, what I was told, it's all about the music. It's just about the music, Tasha. It ain't about, we don't know. We do know. If there are police reports, there are charges, okay? Just like Floyd Mayweather around here, you know, able to walk around, do as he please, because he buying diamonds for this.
And I want to be clear again before I get off of here. Do or does Levi agree with all of Robert's or R. Kelly's moral decisions and actions? No, he does not. But this is not supposed to be a theocracy. It's supposed to be a democracy. You understand? You can't just say, I don't agree with him being with 18-year-olds, not lock him up forever. And some of the same people talking, like Charlamagne the God, has done all manner of evil.
Hi, you guys. So I was going to do a video on this topic before, but now since Tasha K is giving me a little open just to kind of, you know, touch on it while someone's in the moment of doing it, I want to speak on this because I was going to do a separate video about the women that are protecting Charlamagne and who are not speaking up. Let me say that. Let me word it that way. And my whole thing about what people have to understand about that Breakfast Club is that what they represent. The Breakfast Club represent a platform where people who don't want to, or they don't have a way of getting to, you know, a broad minority group of people in a certain demographic, right? And so for them, the Breakfast Club draws in those audiences across the country, because I think they say they have 77 stations that they're broadcasted on across the country. So that's a lot of young people that the Breakfast Club gets to influence, and people get to go on that platform and try to influence these young people into buying their books, their music, their movies, so on and so forth, or fall into their BS that they sell it, right? So that's what the Breakfast Club represents. And this is why people are not speaking up against Charlamagne, because they don't want to dismantle that platform until it can be honestly replaced. And so these women who all of a sudden become such big advocates for women when it comes to football players and certain athletes, they don't become, you know, they lose all of that when they get in the room with Charlamagne, right? All of a sudden, they don't think in that same mindset about someone who was a part of harming two 15-year-old girls. So, and even when the charges, that the lesser charges don't mean, they don't even sound good either. The lesser charges that he was charged with, that doesn't sound good that he allowed these kids to be abused, to be harmed, traumatized. I mean, cut it out. So my whole thing, and this is where I agree with Kwame, and this is why R. Kelly's cousin was speaking on this as well, is because there is a hypocrisy, and we're allowing certain people to do things, and we can overlook it, but we don't want to overlook it with other people. And there have already been people on Versus who've had charges of against, you know, with issues with women, who have promoted harming women in music. Let's talk about that. And I didn't hear Tasha K saying this person or that person should not have been there. These people have already been on there. So, you know, we have to be mindful when we're using our platforms, I guess, to say certain things and think that people can't pick up on the fact that you're not saying that for these other people. But a lot of these people, like these Jemele Hill, these Tamika Mallorys, and all these people, they are aware that this talk is going on around Charlamagne, you know, and that he hasn't came out and cleared up the fact that he lied about a lot of things in that case. You know, he was saying he was 20 years old. In the very beginning, I think when this story first came out, even before the Jessica Reed situation came up, he was saying that he was falsely accused of rape. And see, he doesn't use that type of language around that now. because the girl is out here talking, and he can't say that because that those police reports and all that stuff has been pulled, and he was in fact charged with that, even though he was able to plead to a lesser charge because there was no cooperation from the mother. You know, so he didn't come back and clear up anything. No one has held him accountable for saying the things that he said. He just gets to put this whole mental health defense out here, and people are just supposed to let that fly. JK is saying, do you think that she's just saying that just to create a story? Do you really feel that she feels a way as far as women's rights are being violated by supporting guys who have these charges? Because like I said, there would not be a versus, because there is a list of people who have had issues. And I think she brought up child support as well. I mean, that's going to wipe a lot of people out of being able to participate in versus. I mean, what do you think they should use as a measure to who they should allow to go on this platform? Because I think that Tim and Switzer are not thinking about it in that respect. I think they're thinking about, you know, like they said, the charts, who was on the charts at the same time, who had the 20 hits, you know, just to kind of, you know, celebrate these artists in that way. I don't think that they thought we need to play into people's personal lives, but maybe now with endorsements coming into play, maybe they should do. But let me know what you guys think in the comments. Do you think that that will ever become an issue with verses, in particular verses? Like I said, certain people have already been on there, and I'm going to be messy and start dropping names. Some of y'all know who I'm talking about. Some of y'all may not. But people have already been on there. But do you think going forward they should be more considerate about certain things that people may have on them or records? Let me know in the comments. Because my thing is, if you're going to do that to Bow Wow and to Soulja Boy, you need to do that to everybody. You know, if you're going to do certain things towards certain celebrities, that needs to be the measure for everyone. And that's just how I feel about it. I don't think there is special treatment for certain people. And that goes for the old school people that y'all probably don't even know got stuff on them, to the young ones. That's how I feel about it. Everybody should be treated equally and the same, or just don't do it at all. But I don't think that it's okay for her to single out these guys and don't single out everybody else. In particular, since Josh K been out here supporting R. Kelly herself. Like, she was out here talking a major mess about Aaliyah and her mother. So it's kind of, it looks really bad that she's doing that. You know, you can't, how you not see a problem with all that stuff R. Kelly's been accused of? And but you want to paint Soulja Boy and Bow Wow as poster guys for domestic violence. And I'm not excusing anyone's behavior. I mean, I feel like if people feel strongly about things like that, they won't watch it anyway. So that's how I feel about it. But if you're going to start saying that they need to not let people on, then that means they need to not let anybody with those charges on. Let me know what you guys think in the comments, and I'll see you in the next video.